हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर, दैट इज़ इंडियन इकोनॉमी एट द ईव ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस। सो दिस इज़ द बेसिकली द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ इंडियन इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट, एंड लेटर ऑन वी विल स्टार्ट विद द मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स ऑल्सो। सो बिफोर दैट वी आर फर्स्ट द फर्स्ट चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद दिस। सो द फर्स्ट चैप्टर इज बेसिकली रिलेटेड विद द India's state at the time of independence, that when we just become independence from the British colonial rule. So what was the condition of India at that particular time? So we are going to discuss that things in this particular chapter. So here in this chapter we are going to discuss so many points which you can have a look on that. We will talk about the condition of Indian economy, like low level of economic development in India, backward agriculture sector, less developed industrial sector, foreign trade, how was the foreign trade, what was the demographic condition at that time. Demographic conditions are basically related with the population in that particular area. So we will talk about India's population, India's mortality rate, India's birth rate, the year of great divide, we are going to talk in that. So basically it's an interesting chapter. Along with that, underdeveloped infrastructure, we will talk, and more dependent on primary sector. Okay, so basically when we talk about the Indian economic development, so at that time we have seen that there are some economist, Dr. V.K. R.V. Rao, he suggested the growth rate that was around 2% per annum was the GDP at that particular time, and he is the first person who is going to calculate this GDP and all this. So that name we must have to remember, Dr. V.K. R.V. Rao. Along with that, now we will, in this chapter, we'll go ahead and then we will talk about the backward agriculture sector. So basically the Indian agriculture system was very backward. We do not have that particular new equipments with us. Along with that, at the time of Britishers colonial rule, almost 200 years Britishers has ruled on us. It started in 1757 to 1947, almost 190 years they have ruled on us. So now basically during that particular period, there was some system about the agriculture, that was land tenure system. In this land tenure system, Jamindari system was followed, Mahalwari system and Royatwari system. Jamindari system was basically in that some Jamindars are there, so they will collect the rent or they will collect the taxes from the peasants and they are giving to the Britishers. In the Mahalwadi system, it is just like the same. In Mahalwadi system, the whole village is divided into some kind of mahals or in some areas, and like that they are taking it from the Mukhya was there, and from Mukhya they are taking rent. And then the same way the Royatwadi system also was there. And after that, forced commercialization of agriculture also was there. Okay, partition of the country was the another major factor of backward industrial backward agriculture sector. Along with that, if we talk about this things, that is less developed industrial sector also, because of the deindustrialization. And at that time we were very rich in the handicraft industry, and Britishers has ruined that handicraft industry also at that particular time. And the capital goods industries were lacking. Capital goods industries are those industries through which we can produce more goods, like machinery. We were very backward in producing the machineries. So that was the main problem at that time. Limited operations of the public sector, government was not there in every kind of production and all that. Discriminate tariff policy, that was the main reason, because the Britishers has adopted this particular policy, and they are putting so much tariffs for the Indian products, and for the British made products they are not charging any kind of taxes. So that was also we can say that it's a very backward point for us. So that due to that we are just lacking in that. Lack of heavy and basic industry, and the one major thing that they have given, that introduction of Indian railways, that we have now also we are using it. So the railway invention was very good from the British side. Okay, and the next one is foreign trade characteristics. If we talk foreign trade, India become the exporter of the raw material and importer of finished goods. That was the title given to the India, that India is only exporting the raw material. India is not at all producing any kind of goods in India. ब्रिटेन हैड द मोनोपोली और कंट्रोल ऑन द फॉरेन ट्रेड एंड इंडियाज़ टोटल वेल्थ इज़ गोइंग इन टू द ड्रेन. ड्रेन मीन्स टोटल इट्स गोइंग टू बी वेस्टेज बिकॉज वट एवर द इंडियंस आर अर्निंग दैट अर्निंग इज टोटली कलेक्टेड बाय द ब्रिटिशर्स इन द फॉर्म ऑफ टैक्सेस एंड दे आर यूजिंग दैट टैक्सेस फॉर द वेलफेयर ऑफ देयर ओन और दे आर गिविंग दैट मनी फॉर द डेवलपमेंट इन द ब्रिटेन नॉट इन द इंडिया. दैट वॉज द मेन पॉइंट्स फॉर दैट द फॉरन सेक्टर वॉज वेरी बैकवर्ड एट दैट टाइम. Along with that, if we talk about the adverse demographic condition already I have told you that the demographic conditions are basically related with the population condition at that particular time. Independence, at the time of independence, the population condition was that high death rate along with that high birth rate. Okay, per thousand if we are talk about, okay. High infant mortality rate 218 per thousand. If 1000 children are taking birth, out of that 218 are died. Okay, low literacy, 84% people were illiterate and the life expectancy is only 34 years. Means on an average a person is having a life of only 34 years, not more than that he is living. Okay, so that was the so many demographic condition, lack of public health also there. So, and female literacy level was very low, it's around 7%, only 7% females were literate at that time. Okay, along with that, next we will talk about in this chapter, that is around, okay, that is related with the whatever they have give, the facilities which are lacking here, like good roads, electricity generation, health, education, these are the things which are lacking. Along with that, more dependence on the primary sector. Total, the around 85-84% people were dependent on agriculture. 72% was engaged. That time the figure was given, but more than 84-85% was dependent on labor. Okay, 10% were manufacturing and all this. So that was the data. Some positive sides effect of the British rule. Yes, it is very much important. Okay. It is very much important because what we have learned from the Britishers, that was very important because Britishers in this 200 years period, we have learned so many things from the Britishers and Britishers did that for the benefits of the Indians and we are using that benefits. Now provided transport facility largely in terms of railway. We got railway from the Britishers, development of ports, okay. Provisions of post and telegraph services. British government left a base of a strong and efficient administrative setup. Administrative was very good from the Britishers and political and economic unification of the country. Okay, and banking and monetary system is also introduced by the Britishers in India. So these are the things, these are the very what we can say, these are the important or some positive impact of Britishers in India. Okay, so next so now we will talk about the NCERT book of Indian Economic Development. So that we will talk about in second part of this next video, because the video will be more too much long. Now it's 8 minutes are over, so we will make a new video for that. Okay, thank you.